Hello students, good morning. We have already started a topic indeterminate form. We have already discussed that there are seven indeterminate form. In our previous lecture, we have done one indeterminate form, that is 0 by 0 form. We have already discussed there indeterminate form can be solved by using the L'Hopital rule. In continuation with that topic, today we will discuss the another indeterminate form, that is infinity by infinity form. Indeterminate form of infinity by infinity. If numerator is infinity, then fraction is infinity. Infinity by something is infinity. But if denominator is infinity, then fraction is zero. Anything by divided by infinity is equal to zero. But about the limit, if both numerator and denominator are infinity, so this type of fraction is called the indeterminate form, and it will be solved by using the L'Hopital rule. Now I am taking one example. Using L'Hopital rule, evaluate limit x approaches to 0 positive. Now positive sign is for log term there, because log is always in positive form, that's why log tan 2x upon log tan x. According to solution, first step, we will approach is 0 there. Tan 0 is 0. Tan 0 is 0. Now log 0 is infinity. Log 0 is infinity. It means it is infinity upon infinity form. That means we will solve it by using the L'Hopital rule. According to L'Hopital rule, we will differentiate numerator as well as the denominator. Now this is the compositions of the three functions here. Log, t ratio, then angle. When we differentiate this, we will differentiate step by step there. First of all, it's the term of log. Differentiation of log means the reciprocal of the term there. So what term is there? Tan 2x. The reciprocal of tan 2x is 1 upon tan 2x. Now it's term of tan x. Tan differentiation is secant square theta. So what is theta here? 2x. That means there is secant square 2x. Now third is the turn of the angle. So 2x differentiation is 2 there. The full fraction become 1 upon tan 2x secant square 2x into 2. Now about denominator, log term 1 upon tan x, and tan x differentiation is secant square x. Now secant square x, secant is the reciprocal of cos. We will convert secant square 2x into 1 upon cos square 2x. And tan 2x, we will convert it into sin 2x upon cos 2x. Same way in denominator here. The fraction will become in this form. Limit as it is there. 2 as it is there. Cos 2x upon sin 2x. Tan is in the 1 upon form there. That's why it is in the reciprocal form. Cos 2x upon sin 2x. Cos square 2x. Now 1 cos 2x is cancelled with 1 cos 2x. And in denominator, term is cos x upon sin x upon cos square x. Again, 1 cos x and cos x term is cancelled. Now, in denominator, this will go up and multiply with this 2. So, it will become 2 sin x cos x. In denominator, value will be equal to sin 2x and cos 2x. Therefore, 2 sin x cos x. This is a formula, sin 2x. In denominator, sin 2x is already there, cos 2x. Sin 2x and sin 2x is cutting. Now it will be equal to limit x approaches to 0, 1 upon cos 2x. Now when we approach 0 here, cos 0 means the 1 upon 1 is 1 there. Now I am taking one more example for more understanding. Now in this case, limit x approaches to pi by 2 is there. Tan 3x and tan x is there. When we approach pi by 2, 3 into pi by 2, it will become the 3 pi by 2. And when it approaches to here, it will be equal to the pi by 2. Now before solving this concept, let us recall what we have done in the plus 1. Pi by 2 and 3 pi by 2. Vertical line is for the fractional pi and horizontal line is for the simple pi. 2 pi and pi is there. Its values are same, but in opposite sign. Pi by 2 and 3 pi by 2, t ratio again values are same but in opposite sign. If pi by 2 is having 1, the 3 pi by 2 value will be equal to minus 1. We will use this relation here. Limit as it is there. When we approach is pi 3 into pi by 2, so it will become 3 pi by 2. So 3 pi 10 pi by 2 is infinity, so 3 pi by 2 is also infinity. So it is the form of infinity by infinity form. When it is indeterminate form, how will we solve it? We solve it by the using L'Hopital rule. According to this rule, differentiation of the numerator as well as the differentiation of the denominator here. Now, tan 3x. Tan differentiation first, that is the secant square theta. Theta is 3x here. Now, it's the tan of the angle there into 3. Same way, tan x differentiation is secant square x and x differentiation is 1 there. Now, secant square is the reciprocal of cos. So, it will become 3 as it is there. And it will become cos square 3x in denominator. And this secant square, by taking 1 upon cos square x, it will become the numerator here. Now, we again approach is pi by 2 here. Cos square pi by 2. Now, cos pi by 2, cos 90 is 0. Same way, 3 pi by 2, opposite, again it is 0. So, it is a form of 0 determinate form. Now, we will again apply the L'Hopital rule. According to that rule, we will differentiate numerator as well as we will differentiate the denominator here. Now, again it is the compositions of the functions there. Degree is also there. T ratio is also there. We will solve first degree. Then we will solve the T ratio. Then in the denominator form, we will solve degree, T ratio, then angles there. Now, when we solve these fractions, it will be give a result 3 into minus 2 cos x sin x. Degree is 2 there, then 2 cos x. Now cos x differentiation is minus sin x. Same way for the denominator. Cos 3x differentiation is sin 3x. Minus sin 3x is there. Minus 2 and minus 2 is cutting. 3 and 3 is also cutting there. Now students, if I approach pi by 2 in this term again, full term will give you again the 0 by 0 form. But we can do one thing more here. That's sin x and sin 3x we can take the separate because sin pi by 2 value is 1. Now I am taking this step here, sin x and sin 3x. I am taking separate these two values. Now sin x upon sin 3x, limit x pi by 2 is there. And cos 3x is separate form there. Limit x approaches to pi by 2 is here. Now, when we approach is limit here, to sin pi by 2. Sin pi by 2, sin 90 is 1. Now, 3 pi by 2. 3 pi by 2 means minus 1. Opposite sign now. The value same but opposite in sign. So, 1 and 1 is cancelled. Now, it is easy here now because sin term is totally finished here. No need to differentiation that term. That we have used pi by 2 separate for sine case. Now 1 and 1 is cancelled here. This one I will take it forward. It will come here. Limit x approaches to pi by 2 by L'Hopital rule. Because when we approach is pi by 2 for cos case now, it will again equal to 0 by 0 form, which is indeterminate form. And indeterminate form solved by only one rule, that is the L'Hopital rule. Now, when we differentiate cos x is there, the answer will be equal to minus sin x. When we differentiate cos 3x there, the answer will be equal to minus 3 sin 3x. So, minus 1 is already there. When we approach is pi by 2 in this form, so sin pi by 2 is 1 and 3 pi by 2 is minus 1. When we cancel this term, minus and minus is cancelled here, the answer is 1 by 3. Now, students, you will receive one link related to this topic and your homework sum will also be there. Do more and more practice related to this topic. I hope you will do. Thank you. And more practice related to this topic. I hope you will do. Thank you.